up, kings and queens? It's your girl, Essentially K. If you are new to my channel, welcome. If you're returning, what's good? Happy Feel Good Friday. I hope that you guys have had an amazing week so far. I know that a lot of things have been happening as far as, like, you know, the weather is getting crazy all over the country, not just in certain areas. So I pray that you all are safe wherever you are and warm. Today is not going to be a very long video at all. I just kind of wanted to talk to you guys about some of my favorite, like, natural products. Some of them are very recent to my, you know, purchases, but so far I absolutely love them. And I'm not going to go in any particular order, I don't think. I kind of just want to jump straight into it. If you haven't done so, make sure that you hit the subscribe button down below. Tap the notification bell so that you don't miss any weekly uploads every Friday and Sunday. All right, you guys. So as you know, if you've been following my channel or my social media, you know that I'm very, very, very big on trying to convert every product that I use into using something that is natural. So over the past maybe year to year and a half, maybe, I started taking out certain products that were damaging to my body, you know, internally and externally. And for those of you who do not know, I have extremely sensitive skin. I've always had very sensitive skin, so the smallest change in, like, my routine products can cause me to have some type of skin irritation or just, like, drying my skin out, itchiness, all that kind of stuff, which is actually kind of what prompted my business, KD Essentials Organic Skincare, which I talked about in the past couple videos. But for those of you who did not see that video, my product line will be launching on March 19th. It is a Friday, and my website will be live. Yeah, I'm very excited about that. But let's go ahead and get into some of these products. So while we're on the topic of KD Essentials Organic Skincare, my favorite, actually it's not my favorite, it's one of my favorite. All of my products are my favorite. My lemon meringue shea butter. Oh my goodness. This right here, y'all. I'm gonna open it. Let me see if y'all can smell it. Can y'all smell it? Y'all, it smells so good. Even though it's thick when you, like, first touch it, I'm gonna show it to y'all. I purposefully left my hands ashy because I washed them again. But it's like a thicker... It's like a thicker consistency, but what's good about this is that it doesn't take long for it to activate and melt into your skin. So watch this. We're gonna have it a few seconds. Boom, right? It's already melted. And it's so hydrating and so moisturizing. And this is not even necessarily meant to be like a plug for my business, even though it is kind of. It's just one of my favorite daily products. Y'all, look at that. I should have showed y'all before. Ooh, she's shining. She's shining, y'all. I'm so excited. But yeah, so my favorite time to use this is like right after I get out of the shower. But obviously, like, the more you wash your hands, the more it's going to be dry, especially in the wintertime. And I've been washing my hands nonstop all day. So I needed to go ahead and put some more on. And it goes a long way. Like, you saw that I didn't really use a lot on or get a lot out. And I'm good. So that's one of my favorite products, and it just so happens to be one of my personally made, you know, from my business products. That one will be on sale when I launch on March 19th. So look out for the lemon meringue body butter. Moving along, y'all, and these is like two different products that I want to talk about, but it's the same company. So the company that I want to discuss is Hello. I think it's called Hello. I think that's it. Yeah, Hello. I think that's all it's called. But anyway, this is an activated charcoal. What is a charcoal, y'all? Activated charcoal toothpaste. And it has fresh mint and coconut oil. I don't know if you guys can see that. But I'm actually almost out. I've had this tube for probably like 2.5 months, I think. But it goes a long way. I wish I could show it to y'all, but it comes out kind of fast. comes out kind of fast, and I'm scared I'm gonna make a mess. But it is a charcoal toothpaste, and it leaves your teeth looking super duper clean. What I really like about this particular toothpaste is that it's never tested on animals, it's cruelty free, it's vegan. What else? It doesn't have any like dyes, it's free from dyes and fluorides, microbeads, and sulfates, pretty much everything that it could have in it. Oh, and no parabens. It doesn't have any parabens. So pretty much everything that it could have in it to be dangerous, it is free of. So I love, love, love this toothpaste. Now I'm gonna be honest now. I don't care for the taste of it. Even though it has, you know, fresh mint in it, I still don't really care for the taste, but I love how it makes my teeth look. Oh yeah. And how it makes my teeth feel. So I can put up with the taste. It's not horrible. It's not a horrible taste. It's just not gonna taste like your normal, like minty, super duper minty, fresh, like Colgate or Crest or whatever, you know. Moving along to the same brand, just a different product. It is the Hello Sunshine natural mint with aloe vera and coconut oil mouthwash. And I surprisingly really like this mouthwash. I was kind of nervous at first because, you know, with mouth, anything that has to do with like toothpaste or mouthwashes, you just really want it to leave you feeling like super refreshed and clean. And after I tried the toothpaste before I got the mouthwash, and after I tasted the toothpaste, I was like, you know, I'm not really looking forward to like gargling with something that is that type of taste. Even though, again, it's not horrible, it's just not what you would, you know, normally expect. But then I got this, y'all, and it tastes like regular mouthwash. Like, I don't know, but it promotes healthy gums, prevents plaque, gingivitis, and it doesn't have any alcohol in it. Never tested on animals. Again, this is cruelty free as well. No alcohol, no dyes, no artificial sweeteners or flavors. No SLS or sulfates. Yeah, it's just a really good alternative, y'all. And now I'm not gonna lie, they are kind of pricey, and taking into consideration the price of all of your other toothpaste, y'all, I am tripping over my words today. All day long I've been tripping over my words. Anyway, in comparison to some of your like regular brands for toothpaste and mouthwash, it is a little more pricey, but it goes a long way and it's most definitely worth it. And nothing in this video, not about those products, but nothing in this video is sponsored at all. I'm just kind of sharing, y'all. I'm over it. I'm just kind of sharing with you guys some of my favorites, because if they've changed my life, then I know they can change yours. All right, moving on to my deodorant. I use the Native brand. Y'all, ignore my nails. I do this thing where, like, when I get stressed or I get nervous or bored sometimes, mainly when I'm stressed, I just pick at my nails. So that's why my nails, like, most of the time when I film, my nails look a mess, but it's because I've recently picked my nails, like, ridiculous. Ridiculous. And it's something that I've been trying to stop for forever, and I'll let them grow out and then I'll get stressed and then I'll pick them again. Like, it's just annoying. So ignore my fingers when I show y'all this stuff. But anyway, the native brand, I love their deodorant. This one is the coconut vanilla. I have tried, I think it was like a eucalyptus one, maybe whatever one, I think has like green writing. It might have been eucalyptus, I don't know, but the coconut vanilla is my favorite one, and it's paraben free, aluminum free, and yeah, y'all, it just smells good. And I used to break out sometimes underneath my arms depending on what deodorant I use, and then some just didn't feel like they were working, they weren't strong enough. But y'all, and I know a lot of people are like, I can't use natural deodorant, it's not strong enough. Once you detox your body and you detox your underarms, like, you'll notice that you won't sweat as much, and when you do sweat, it won't really have a smell to it as bad. But you gotta seriously detox your arms. Like, before I started using this, I actually started to detox my arms, and after I would shower, I would put on like tea tree oil, and I wouldn't put deodorant. I didn't wear deodorant, I think, for like 3 or 4 weeks straight, just to detox my arms and unclog my pores from all the other bad deodorants that I used previously that had aluminum in it, and you know, just things that could really clog up my pores and harm me in the long run. So I started to detox my underarms. I would use coconut oil, tea tree oil, and that was it. And I was fine. And I'm not just gassing y'all. Like, it actually, once you detox your arms, you can use lemon juice. I know sometimes people will do that, like fresh squeezed lemon juice. Now, I wouldn't suggest or recommend to do that if you have like an open cut from like shaving or something. I don't know. Or if you have like some type of sensitivity that would be like an open wound, kind of, if you have it under your arm, because I'm sure that would burn. But I love, 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 love the fact that I transitioned to this deodorant. Now, I know there are some other good all-natural deodorants. I just personally normally use Native. I don't think I've ever used another brand. But this is like my go-to. It is expensive though, so if you can find it on sale or buy it in bulk. I bought mine this last time off of Amazon. My sister called me and was like, oh my gosh, they have your deodorant on Amazon, 3 for $25. And I jumped on it because I think in most stores, they're anywhere from like $10 to like $12 per bar. So I definitely jumped on it to get my 3 in a pack for like $25, because they can be pretty pricey, and they're not like the biggest, they're not like the, you know, biggest little container. It actually looks bigger on the screen than it does in real life, but it's worth it. It goes a long way, and I haven't had any type of skin irritations. They work just as good or actually better than, you know, all the normal deodorants that you probably are used to. All right, moving along to the last brand. I'm going to kind of talk about these together, and fellas, this is not really for you, or not really, it's actually not for you, but I'm speaking to my ladies for a second. The L brand, I think is the name of it, y'all. I don't even know what the name of this is. Let me see. This is L. I think it's called This Is L. So ladies, y'all might have seen these, I think, at Target. This is where I got these. They probably have them in other places, unless they only have like some type of partnership with Target. But they're like panty liners and pads. They have all kind of stuff, wipes and just everything that you would need for your, you know, cycle or whatever. And they are organic, y'all. The whole reason I went in there is to look for the Honest brand. Not Honest brand. Y'all, my sister got me saying Honest brand. I meant to say the Honey Pot. When I discussed it with her, she said the Honest brand, and now it's just stuck in my head. So not the Honest brand, that is definitely for babies, but the Honey Pot. I went in there looking for that because, one, they're black owned. Hello, shout out to Black History Month. But they're black owned and they're organic. So I went into Target looking for that, but I couldn't find anything besides, I think, like the sprays they had and some wipes and things like that. But I was looking for actual like panty liners and pads and stuff like that. So because I needed something in that moment, I went with an alternative. So y'all, Skim Likely is calling me again. I knew I should have used my actual camera and not my phone. But anyway, y'all, so these particular pads and panty liners, I can't speak for every single product that they have, but these are the ones that I used the last time for my cycle, and it made a world of difference. So it doesn't have, it says no synthetic pesticides, dyes, or fragrances. It's organic cotton. Yeah, and it just kind of talks about the type of coverage that it gives you. Y'all, this was so good for me because a lot of times as women, they don't teach us about the harmful things that may be in our like sanitary wipes, sanitary pads, all those kind of things. And instead, we're just, you know, using what we've been brought up on, not realizing that the materials in those things can actually harm us way more than we expected it to. And we're thinking, you know, we're just taking care of ourselves by buying all of these like name brand, like pads, panty liners, wipes, whatever. And a lot of the times those things have so many toxins in them and so many chemicals, and it's really messing us up from the inside out. So I tried these, and I have always been the type of person who had like really bad menstrual cycles, like very bad, to the point where I'm like balled up in a corner on my bed, like I don't want to move, I don't want to talk for days at a time. Research that I've noticed is a lot of times the materials that our pads and our panty liners and tampons too can be made out of actually increases our symptoms, right? So I tried these out last month, and when I tell y'all, that was the best, quote unquote, best cycle in my entire life. I'm not lying. Like, my flow was different, and this might be TMI, but I feel like there's a lady out there that can, or a girl out there that can use this information. So my flow was different. My pain from like cramps was almost non-existent. My back aches still kind of hurt a little bit, not gonna lie, but it wasn't nearly what it normally is. And then I normally have like headaches and nausea and stuff like that, and it just was not really there as much, you know. So I really personally believe, and I'm gonna try it again, you know, the next time, but I honestly believe that me switching my product actually helped me, because the type of toxins that were in the other products that I was using before was definitely affecting how I felt during my cycle. So girls, I still am going to be purchasing from the Honey Pot because I want to support them, but obviously I'm going to wait until I use the rest of these. Comment down below if you've ever switched to organic feminine products and if it made a difference for you or not. These, again, I said I purchased at Target, and they actually come in a bigger bulk than normal feminine products, and they were like the same price or cheaper. So that's all I really have to say about that. I hope that helped somebody out, because it definitely helped me out the last month. I don't really have anything else for y'all. Comment down below if you've ever used any of the products I talked about today. For the shea butter, the body butter, you guys can purchase that on my website starting March 19th. And yeah, I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day and weekend. Peace and positivity, kings and queens. I'm out.